I am no doctor or expert in any way, but what I sure am, is a kidney stone sufferer. I recall the first stone I got, a long time ago, back in my 20s. A sudden and excruciating pain striking around the kidney area, making me roll onto the floor not knowing which position to take in order to alleviate the pain. I was rushed to the hospital where I was kept under observation for 3 to 4 days. I was given heavy doses of a painkilling injection, as there was no other remedy available. Eventually, the tiny stone traveled through the urinary tract and was finally ejected. What a relief! On leaving the hospital, the doctor warned me that this is, most of the time, a recurring condition. Knowing that this could happen again, I was determined to investigate further into the matter. A friend of mine from Egypt told me that this ailment is prevalent there as well as in the countries surrounding the Mediterranean Sea and it could be cured with local herbal medicine. On this note, I started investigating and found out with the help of an Egyptian herbalist, that kidney stones could be treated efficiently with the seeds of a flower growing in the desert called Bisra el-Kila. This medicine has been used in Egypt for centuries. The recipe is quite simple, bring some water to the boil, throw in a tablespoon full of these seeds, simmer for 10 minutes, pass the liquid through a strainer, let it cool down and drink it. A very small glass will do. But I must warn you, the taste is quite bitter. According to the herbalist that we met, this potion has the ability to expand and enlarge the urinary tract, thus facilitating the passage of the kidney stone. A stone of 2 mm to 3 mm should be passed in a matter of 2 to 4 hours. This is what happens to me. Obviously, not everybody is built the same, it may take longer with different individuals. For many years, I have given this potion to numerous friends and acquaintances of mine, when premonitory signs of pain have occurred. The pain was gone in a matter of hours. The best thing is its ridiculous price. On the Egyptian markets, a pound of these seeds costs the equivalent of $1 and lasts for years. The Latin name for this plant is Ami Visnaga, Kila. Do a search on Google, it seems that you could find it elsewhere around the world.